So the next part of sedimentation analysis is the hydrometer method. So this also follows the Stokes law. It means that the settling velocity we are again going to calculate using the Stokes law, which gives the velocity as gamma s minus gamma l d square by 80 mu, which is equal to he by t. So this he, which was constant in the pipette method, is not a constant here, and it will vary with time, and normally it increases with time. So we'll see how that happens. And so another difference between the pipette method and the hydrometer method is that in the pipette method we were drawing out the sample using pipette at different time intervals. We were drawing out some sample using pipette, but in this method we don't need to draw out any sample. We can calculate the specific gravity of the solids using the hydrometer, and from there we establish a relationship so that we can find out the concentration of solids at he and at time t. So that we'll use, and if we divide it by the concentration of solids at t is equal to 0, so we'll get the percentage finer than d, and d at the height he, d is calculated using the Stokes law formula. So the hydrometer is a device which works on the buoyancy principle, and the weight of solids in suspension is calculated by indirectly reading the density of soil suspension, as I said. So we find hydrometer is calibrated in such a way that it indirectly gives us the specific gravity, and so using that we find out the weight of solids in suspension, and that we'll see how we do it. So if it is a given sample, and so if there is no hydrometer into it, it is like this, and if we put hydrometer into the sample, so because hydrometer is having some volume, the volume of the hydrometer is considered to be the volume of the hydrometer bulb. This part does not contribute anything to the volume. The stem part does not contribute to the volume, just the bulb of the hydrometer, just this part contributes to the volume. So because of the buoyancy, if the hydrometer is immersed into the water, so it will displace some water. So how much will be the displacement? If VH is the volume of the hydrometer and AJ is the area of this jar, AJ, so volume of hydrometer will be equal to the volume of displaced liquid. So from here H is found out as VH upon AJ. H dash, so it is termed as VH upon AJ, and this is the reference line at which we want to calculate the density of liquid. So this is the point where, if we are reading the reading here, it will be corresponding to this point. So we need to reach up to this point. It will be given as the effective height. So effective height can be written as h. H is the height between the reading of the hydrometer and its neck, h plus h by 2. So here we assume that the hydrometer CG of the hydrometer bulb divides this area into two parts. So h by 2 is above this and h by 2 is below this part. So h plus h by 2 is this part, and we are calculating at this point, so plus VH upon 2AJ. And because there was a rise in the hydrometer level, equal to VH upon AJ, so we have to deduct that rise. So minus VH upon AJ. So once again, if we see, this is the normal level of hydrometer and this is one reference line. I'm saying that at this line we want to calculate the density. So now if we have put hydrometer, so this liquid which was, now it is at this level, these are the points, and these points were here before, so they have risen above this level, they have gone above the level. So now we are trying to find out the actual level between the points. So h is the distance between this neck of the hydrometer and the point where the reading is being made, plus h by 2 is the center of this hydrometer bulb, VH upon 2J, this part will displace. If this is the total displacement, so because we are assuming it to this, the center of the bulb is dividing it into two parts, so this part is will displace half. So this is VH upon 2AJ, and to deduct this part, we are deducting the VH by AJ. So from here, HE is equal to H plus 1 by 2 H minus VH upon AJ. This is the formula for effective height in a hydrometer. After that, a relationship is established between the hydrometer reading, let's say that is RH, and it is generally given as 1 plus RH by 1000 is equal to specific gravity of soil suspension at HE. So it will be equal to specific gravity of soil suspension, we can write as density of soil suspension divided by density of water. Now this is again at HE. Now for the numerator part, let's say this is equation 1, density of soil suspension is equal to density of water plus immersed weight of solids per unit volume. Now it can be written as gamma W plus immersed unit weight gamma S minus gamma W into VS. This will give us the immersed weight and divided by total volume, that is VS plus VW, volume of water plus volume of solids. So from here, if I take gamma S common in this equation, so it is equal to gamma W plus VS gamma S divided by VS plus VW and 1 minus gamma W divided by gamma S. And it can be written as gamma W plus VS gamma S upon VS plus VW. VS gamma S is the weight of the solids and VS plus VW is the total volume of suspension. So it is the weight of solids per total volume of suspension. So we write it as WD is VS gamma S upon VS plus VW. So WD 1 minus gamma S upon gamma W is the specific gravity. And so this value we can put in the equation 1 again. So from there we'll get 1 plus RH upon 1000 is equal to gamma w plus w d 1 minus 1 upon gs upon gamma w. And from here, rh by 1000 is equal to 1 wd upon gamma w 1 minus 1 upon gs. And from here we can find out the wd. Wd is rh gamma w 1000 1 minus 1 upon gs. So this wd is the concentration of solids at depth he and at time t. So because it is corresponding to the hydrometer reading h, so this hydrometer reading h will be at the depth of he, and this, as we saw, this was the weight of the solids per total volume of the suspension. So this will give us the weight of the solids at height he, and if we divide it by w, that is weight of the solids in the initial concentration of solids. So it will give us the percentage finer than d. So if we have these two values, then we can plot the grain size distribution curve. Now there are some corrections to the hydrometer readings, that is meniscus correction, temperature correction, and deflocculating agent correction. So one thing to notice in the hydrometer is that the hydrometer readings are increasing in the bottom side. So the readings will be 5, 10, 15, 20. It is increasing downwards. What is the meniscus correction? When we take the reading, it will form a meniscus like this. So we should take the bottom value of this meniscus. But because of the soil suspension, this liquid will be opaque, so we cannot read this bottom value. We take this top value, and so if we are taking the top value, so it will give us a smaller value, but the actual value will be bigger than that. So we'll add a correction of Cn. And then next is the temperature correction. It can be positive or negative. Meniscus correction will always be positive because, as I said, we have to take the lower level of meniscus, but we are taking the upper level of meniscus, and upper level of meniscus will give us a smaller value. So the actual value will be bigger than that. So this correction will be added. Temperature correction can be subtractive or additive depending upon the temperature. If we are increasing the temperature, then the density of the liquid will decrease, and if the density of liquid is decreasing, then more weight of the liquid has to be replaced to counterbalance the weight of the hydrometer. So if the density is more, then hydrometer will come down to a greater depth than it should be. So the normal temperature at which it is calibrated is 27 degrees Celsius. So this is the reference temperature we are talking about. So if the temperature is more than this, so the hydrometer will come down further. So if it has come down, so it will give us a smaller value, and which should be bigger than this. The actual value should be bigger than this. So the correction will be positive. So if temperature T greater than 27 degrees Celsius, correction positive, and T less than 27 degrees Celsius, correction will be negative. And the deflocculating agent correction, it will always be negative, because if we are adding some deflocculating agent in our liquid, so the density will increase. So if the density has increased, so the if in a normal liquid the hydrometer is coming to at depth h, so if density is increased, so
it will come down to a lesser value than h. So if this value is lesser, then we'll get a bigger value from of the reading. So we have to deduct the correction of deflocculating agent. And so that's it for the hydrometer.